So today we are recreating a recipe that I really enjoyed last year in 2019 at Disney's Festival of Holidays, which is the annual holiday festival that takes place at Disney's California Adventure. For those who haven't been, they set up a lot of different food booths and a lot of them have like fun themes. They also have a lot of different bands come and play that represent different religions and cultures and holidays. So yeah, I spent a lot of time there last year. It was really fun. It was a really great time to go and just eat and enjoy the music. But since that's not happening this year, I wanted to recreate some of the recipes that I enjoyed. So hopefully we can make them at home. The one I'm showing you today is the upside down shepherd's pie, which came from the Grandma's Recipes booth. I actually made this for the first time a few weeks ago and it was super easy and simple to make. It seems like it would be complicated because there's a lot of different components, but everything that you have to make is pretty easy. You can do it, don't worry. A lot of the ingredients are probably also things that you have on hand. The one thing that you might not have is this puff pastry. I'm sure there are probably like fancier ones out there, but I figured this one is super easy to find. A lot of like mainstream grocery stores have it, and it is vegan. So it comes with two sheets. I've already used one. I'm thinking this is probably gonna be what I make for Christmas dinner because I don't really feel like making a lot of complicated stuff. And this is like really festive and fun. And I think it's a good choice. So if you guys decide to make it too, make sure to tag me on Instagram so I can see what you made. Oh, one more thing I wanted to mention about these guys is that you should thaw them at room temperature for 40 minutes before you start cooking. So another change that I made to my recipe is that at the Festival of Holidays, they used Impossible Meat as the meat substitute. And it was really good, don't get me wrong, I liked it. But I don't know, there's something that seems more like homey and comfort foody about something like tempeh or like lentils. Like I am 100% a fan of like fake meat substitutes. I think they're super fun. But that's more, for me, that's more like for a fun like burger kind of thing and like not so much for like home cooking. I feel like I'm not really explaining very well what I'm trying to get at, but I think, I mean, it was at the Grandma's Recipes booth and when I picture like if I am like some vegan grandma, I'm probably not gonna be making this with Impossible Meat. I'm gonna be using something a little more grandma-like. I don't know, if one of you guys can read my mind and explain better what I'm trying to say, let me know in the comments. But anyway, I did make this recipe with tempeh and I will probably do it the same way again. It turned out really good, I was really happy with it. Obviously you can use whatever meat substitute, you can use Beyond Meat. I recently tried a new brand called Ozo and it was pretty good. Originally I thought I was gonna try it with lentils. I haven't tried it that way yet, but I think that would be good too. So the recipe itself is pretty straightforward and if you do decide to make small changes like that, I mean, you know what you like to eat, so it's gonna be fine. Like the recipe at Festival of Holidays used peas and carrots as their veggies, and I just had a mix that had like green beans and corn and peas and carrots. And then also for the gravy, I had Better Than Bouillon on hand, so I just looked up an easy gravy recipe. And I wanted it to be easy because I've made gravy before that can be kind of complicated. And since there are a lot of different components to this recipe, I just wanted to make everything as easy as possible. So I will post in the description box the gravy recipe that I use from Better Than Bouillon. But if you have another similar gravy recipe that you like, you can use that if you want to. To be honest, I don't know if the original recipe from Festival of Holidays is like seared into my memory well enough to like know for sure if I'm getting it right. I don't think this is an exact replica, but what I'm saying is like, I don't know if I did like taste test trials, if it would even matter because I don't remember it. Like my Disney memories are fading like Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. So maybe if they have this next Festival of Holidays, I can do some more taste tests and like perfect it. But until then, I think what I've come up with is pretty good. You're also gonna need some Mickey cookie cutters. I got these online probably about a year ago. If you don't have them, I'm realizing that if you're planning to make this for Christmas, it might be a little bit of short notice, but I mean, you can use whatever cookie cutters you want. You can cut those things into squares or whatever shapes. I've even seen people, not with puff pastry, but with other like cookies and stuff, I've seen people try to like freehand Mickey with like a knife. Freehand Mickey with a knife. That sounds vaguely threatening. But yeah, I mean, if you have the Mickey cookie cutters, that's fine. But if you don't, just make them however you want. Although I feel like if you're watching this video, I'm not gonna lie, I feel like there is a good chance that you might already have Mickey cookie cutters. If you're one of those people, let me know in the comments. All right, so that is it for me talking. I'm gonna show you how I made this recipe and definitely let me know if you try it. And I hope you enjoy.
Okay, so I'm not even 100% sure that there were onions in the park version of this recipe, but I feel like diced onions were the right place to start, and I just sautéed these up in some sunflower oil. Next, I started boiling my potatoes, and I cooked these until they were slightly past fork tender, since you're going to be mashing them, and yes, I did have 2 pots full of potatoes just for one person. And in the spirit of keeping things easy for my veggie mixture, I just used a regular frozen veggie blend and I popped them in the microwave so that they would already be cooked and ready to add to my tempeh mixture. So here's where things got a little weird. I cut my Mickey puff pastries and then I just cooked them according to the package directions. But then the parts that I peeled off of the Mickey cutouts, I cooked those as well. And you know what? They were a good snack. Not the best looking, but that's okay. I added my tempeh to the sauteed onions and I just took it out of the package and crumbled it up so it was kind of a texture similar to like ground beef. And you just want to cook it until it's heated thoroughly and it'll get a little bit browned on the outside. So then I drained my potatoes and added them to a bowl with some vegan butter. And on this day I was using Earth Balance. If I remember correctly, I didn't have enough Earth Balance, so I made one bowl with Earth Balance and one bowl I just used oil instead. And then for both batches, I also added some almond milk. And if you don't know how to make mashed potatoes just by eyeballing it, do yourself a favor and get comfortable doing it. I didn't really know how until the last year or so, but it's super easy. Like, I'm not even going to include any specific amounts or measurements here because I want you to learn for yourself. It'll make you a stronger person. Up next, I started the gravy, which was just better than bouillon, cornstarch, and water. It was super easy to make, and I will include that recipe in the description box, or you can just use any other gravy recipe that you like. Once the gravy was done, all I had to do was add it to my tempeh mixture, and I just gradually added it until I had about the amount that I wanted, and I did still have some gravy left over, which I think was a good thing because after I assembled each plate, I added a little bit of gravy on top, and I think that turned out really well. So I hope you all enjoyed this recipe. Like I said, if you decide to make it, make sure to tag me on Instagram so I can see it. And if there are any other recipes that you would like me to make, be sure to let me know in the comments. And I will see you in the next video.